Tuesday, June 11th, at 7 p.m. Just so that everybody knows, participating by phone in tonight's meeting is Ann Hurd and Joe Meyerson. And as I mentioned, we have Captain Dave Farrell from the Fire Department here in person. So our first item is to review FY 2019 year-end transfers, and since you're here, we thought it would make sense to start with the Fire Department's request, so maybe you can just lay it all out, just explain what's going on.
Okay, so I think the letter that you all received, hopefully, lays out some of the issues that we've had with our engine 2. It's a lengthy, laundry list of issues we've had. In order to extend the life of that truck and reduce the workload, there is a heavy rescue truck that Town of West Boylston is retiring. They just got a brand new fire truck to replace it. And that is going on the municipal bid. It actually just went up today. So we weren't sure if we were going to be able to do it for this fiscal year or next fiscal year. And us obtaining the heavy rescue would significantly reduce the workload on engine 2, thereby extending the life so that the next truck replacement, which I believe the chief said was 2023, that truck would make it to the end. And then his intention is to replace that truck since engine 1 was slated to be replaced in 2023, but just got refurbed about a year and a half ago. So it's in much better shape than engine 2 is. So by reducing the workload and having a heavy rescue, we think that's the best dollar value for it. The chief's intention was to purchase the heavy rescue on municipal bid using the current fiscal year's dollars. And we had enough money in our accounts left over from some of the things we have that we would be able to do that comfortably and still have a few hundred dollars left over. Unfortunately, last week, engine 2's fuel tank ruptured in the station, and we had to have it taken out of service and was brought up to Ricky's home in Lancaster that has been up there for the last, since I think the 4th. There's an outside chance we may get that truck back in the next 2 days or so, which would be great because our fleet is limping along right now. But that fuel cell, manufacturer does not have that anymore. They stopped making it. So Ricky's was able to obtain one that he could modify, as well as modify some of the piping on engine 2 to make it work and give us back our truck and have it not leaking anymore.
A new fuel tank?
I think it's a used one. I believe it's a used fuel tank, but it's in very good condition. So because of the unforeseen expense of having that rupture last week, the chief wanted to ask for approval to spend $3,500 to go towards the fuel cell. Additionally, the chief just put on our old SCBA compressor and air tanks and fill station. So we hope to potentially recover $3,000 for that, which would go back into town funds. So it'd be a net of $500 once everything is all through. If we've got the $3,500 from advisory and $3,000 from the old SCBA fill station, it'd be a net of $500 that would be the town would be expending.
Thank you for that explanation. And so I started to ask before the meeting. We got the memo which outlined the potential request for $3,500. But am I understanding that at this time, the chief hasn't decided to formally make a transfer request for FY19?
Correct. We were not, up until today, we were not sure that the truck was going to go up to bid in this current fiscal year.
Okay.
So if it did come up in the next few days or next week, he wanted approval to go forward with purchasing with our current funds and then get reimbursed the $3,500 for engine 2 fuel cell. The truck just went on bid today, and it's open for 13 days.
It's open for how many days?
13 days.
13 days. So the starting is $4,500?
Yes, that's the start. I believe that's the starting.
I mean, I don't know. about this kind of thing. So typically with the mileage and whatever,
yeah,
how much do you think that is worth, that truck?
That truck, $4,500 is a fair value for that truck. It does have some issues which I believe have been quoted out as being costly. The chief is familiar with this truck. He knows exactly what needs to be done, and he believes he can get the work done at a much lower cost. So someone else coming up bidding on it is going to maybe come in lower than the $4,500 because of the work that needs to be done. The chief is confident with the repairs that he has figured out on the truck that we can probably get it for that. West Boylston, you know, would like, he went to the selectmen's meeting and they were happy that a local town in our own region and someone that we rely on mutual aid and they rely on us for mutual aid, they were happy that it potentially could go to one of our towns.
And he knows them pretty well, too.
Yeah, he's a lieutenant on that
yeah.
department, that's right, yes.
But he knows the truck.
Yeah, it's just he cannot make the bid.
Now, I know that you couldn't be here tonight,
yes.
But do you happen to know whether, like, he provided us with some details about what he thought was going to be remaining in his budget to
correct.
Be able to potentially afford the West Boylston street
yes.
truck. Do you know whether he's validated those numbers with the town accountant?
Yes,
okay.
he's been in constant contact with Nanochka, and making sure we've actually, up until today, all of our invoices and all of our equipment that we've purchased are in, and they're either in the next billing cycle going to Nanochka or they're already done. So we don't anticipate anything else unless there's another failure, which we hope not, but we don't. There's nothing on our projection to go and say we want to buy this, and this, and it's going to do a drain on our budget. So we've done everything we can to keep our costs in line and still maintain the apparatus and get the equipment that we need on the trucks.
So we're not retiring anything?
No, we're not retiring. No, we're not
retiring. So it just worries me that if we're not retiring anything, we're still having expenses that will be ongoing for repairs because they are old trucks.
Right.
So that's always a...
Right. Engine 4 is slated to move out of our station to make room for the rescue truck and go into the old fire station and be there as a backup piece. And it would still be available for us for brush season, brush fires, because that's our forester truck. But when it's not brush fire season, it's basically taking up space. So we're going to relocate that. And that does not get much use anymore because it's dedicated for that. It used to be forestry in our winter truck because it was four-wheel drive. And now that we have engine 5, which is four-wheel drive, it took a workload off of that truck. So now it's our forestry truck.
Can you explain more that's reduce the workload on number 2? We have so many calls, 25% of them, I think, need the kind of truck that number 2 is.
Correct.
And now we're going to have 2 old trucks. And I guess I'm where my mind is. If number 2 is fixed, then it's functional.
Right.
You know, does 1 or 2 or few or 10 fewer calls make it? Is it that near its end of life that another truck?
Engine 2 was tasked, it's an incredible workhorse. It was tasked as being a tanker. It's a fire suppression truck. It's our motor vehicle accident truck. It's our rescue truck. It's our hazmat truck. It went on a lot of calls. And by taking rescue out of it, so rescue would be just general rescue, motor vehicle accidents, and hazmat calls. Those would all be handled on the truck. Currently, everything that we would like on our rescue truck, we can't have because there's just not enough space because we had to take away compartment space to put a larger tank to make it a tanker, a tender. By allowing the truck to be a pumper for fire suppression, a tanker, and also it would be our truck that we use dedicated to fire ponds to draft water for us. So that those would be the jobs for Engine 2. And then the heavy rescue would be rescue, hazmat, more vehicle accident.
I understand, but I think the purpose of buying the other truck might be different than assuring that number two lives another year, so to speak. I mean,
we're looking at about 4 years, because it would be replaced in 2023. And we probably would not get it until 2024, because it's about 360 to 400 and somewhere days once you place an order for a truck. So you're looking at potentially 4.5 years before that truck would come in. So this would extend that life. And the truck, you know, the 25% savings by having it go to the rescue, that truck still does a lion's share of the work, because it does a lot of our drafting. It does go on all the fire suppression calls and house calls and house fire calls. So it's removing about probably 50 to 60 calls, maybe 70 calls a year off that workload.
On the truck from West Boylston,
yes.
I think we're aware of an alternator for 500 miles.
Correct.
What else are we aware of?
As far as
that isn't in this order.
As far as Chief has found and has experience with that truck, the electrical problems that the truck experienced is because the alternator is undersized for that truck. And he's spoken to Mack Truck and found that the correct size or bigger would handle the workload of all the electronics on that truck. So that's what the figure, I believe,
463.
Installed. Yes. And then if it needs new batteries, he's looking at $500 in batteries, but that's only if the batteries need to be replaced.
And those deficiencies or those problems were enough to have West Wilson want to cast it off and sell it, right? I mean, you were talking about a green purchaser looking at it may see a lot more wrong than we say, or something like that.
Okay.
What surprises are out there that we might expect?
That's all the chief has relayed to me. That's something that you could ask the chief and he could tell you if there are any other surprises. But as far as we know, as far as I've been told, it's the alternator is would take care of the electrical problems that are involved with the truck.
Okay.
So for that truck to be retired or put out to pasture, and for us to buy it, I think that's your point too.
Yeah,
why are
West
they?
West Wilson doesn't want it for some host of reasons.
Right. So
we are saying we understand there's an electrical problem, and we think that the alternator is the solution to whatever these problems are we haven't defined. And so it's worth $4,500 or whatever that is, plus $500. It's worth $5,000
to
purchase. Have a functioning piece of equipment that we can take duties off the number two.
Sure. So I have no trouble throwing $6,000 out. I think the last year where we've bought a year of a $500,000 replacement cost, which seems to be quite the discount, assuming it functions even a year. I'm kind of surprised it's only been putting on 350 miles a year for its 24-year life. And I wonder if perhaps we can get 20 years out of it.
I believe that truck had a previous life, and when West Boylston purchased it, they put a rescue body on the back.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why it's got such few miles.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know what West Boylston's call volume is for motor vehicle accidents. We may have more motor vehicle accidents that didn't get to see the use that we would have put to put it through. But they opted to go the route of a rescue pumper for their new vehicle to replace the rescue.
How can we see the data on this truck that we're purchasing from, or desire to purchase from West Wilson? You know, do the pumps reach their capacity?
It's not a pumper. It's a walk-through rescue. So it would handle all of the rescue equipment we have for extrication. It would handle all the hazmat equipment we have. It would help out in the wintertime for ice rescue. Right now, we put our ice rescue equipment on between two trucks and roll two trucks to an ice rescue. This would have everything on it in its own spot, and also have room for more equipment if we decide. side, we need more vehicle extrication or rescue equipment on it. So it is not a pumper. So that would not go to a car fire. That would still be designated for engine two.
Automatic or manual transmission?
That I don't know. The chief would know because he's familiar with the truck, very familiar with it. I would venture guess it's going to be automatic because 95 is when they were, mostly everything became automatic in the 90s.
Now we're adding this to the fleet, and it has its own replacement time. And I mean, we've added another vehicle, and so instead of having X number of vehicles that get replaced on a frequency, now we have X plus one.
Right.
We've combined a lot of functionality in number two. Now we're splitting it and we're going
to. The chief has a plan for the vehicle in 2023, 2024. He has a plan for what that is going to be. And again, you can make a rescue pumper like the one he actually built, the West Boylston rescue pumper that they just purchased, and he would go with something similar to that. So it would still increase the workload of the rescue truck by having it go to car fires as well as rescues, but it would not be a tanker. So the compartment space taken up by the water tank is significantly is taken away. Now you have a lot more compartment space to put all of the rescue equipment that we can't put on our current engine to.
I guess another way to ask the question is in 19 or 2023,
correct,
when we get the new number two, this West Wilson truck won't disappear.
We could put it up for bid for someone else, or if another town department wanted to take it, like if the DPW took our engine.
Not the West Wilson.
Okay, yeah.
So it is an option.
It's an option.
It could disappear with number two.
Yes.
And we just replace with one truck.
All right. Once a new rescue pumper came in, potential is there to remove that. We're not going to keep building the fleet.
Yeah,
we don't have the housing for that.
That's where
I'm at. Yeah. No, I don't believe the intention is to build the fleet. It's to make something, make us viable until a new rescue truck can be purchased.
Yes.
Yeah, no, we're not going to expand our fleet.
One more thing, and I don't really care if it's my house on fire with what name is on the truck, but you might want to rename this thing a Bolton Fire Truck.
Oh, no, it will. Yes, it'll be relettered. It'll be relettered and a different number placed on it. No, it would not stay West Boylston, correct?
It's not listed as a cost, but I don't really care. I assume it's negligible.
That I don't know, but I believe that. I believe the chief is planning on using next fiscal year's money to do something.
That's for $10.
Yeah, I think I would venture to say it's more than $310 to have a re-lettered. We also have a firefighter on a department who is a body person, so he could potentially remove all the lettering and labeling and stuff, and it would just be us having our own decals and numbers put on it.
I had a question about whether the rest of the firefighters are aware of the situation and the proposed plan.
I believe, yes, a large majority of them are. The chief is very, very transparent with his plans and the budget constraints we have and where we sit with our funding, so that people know that it's just they know where the money's going and why it's going to certain places. They're very transparent, so I think everybody knows pretty much the intentions of getting that rescue from West Boylston.
Stick a plow on it in 2024.
they do have two of our trucks, mm-hmm. two of our former engines, and now DPW trucks.
All right, so just to take a step back, we have like a certain pot of money still sitting in our fund. And so although you're not asking for us to sign on the dotted line tonight, if we are amenable to this proposal, we should basically subtract potentially $3,500.
Yes, I believe the chief would come through with the transfer request that you're bearing at your next meeting, which was
the 25th.
I believe that's his intention. If, again, we did not know prior to having this scheduled for time that it came up to bid, and the chief texted me just before dinner and said it's up for bid now. So.
What's the possibility that the
No. This is the $3,500 is to pay for the fuel tank for Ricky's towing. This would be open for 13 days, and then we would still be able to pay for it with this current fiscal year.
Okay.
13 days would be the 24th, I guess.
Yeah.
24th.
We also have potentially $3,000 or more.
I'm going to try merging you again, Joe.
Okay.
You dropped a lot. Oh, okay. Alright, I think everybody's back now. Sorry for that.
We also have the potential for $3,000 coming in for
better. Right.
With
the SCB.
Yeah.
With the SCB system. I believe that's until the 21st, if I remember correctly.
Yes.
Yes, the 21st. So,
I don't know that we need a formal motion, but I guess I would poll the group to make sure that people are in agreement with this plan.
Yeah.
Is there anybody not?
I think there are really two decisions, and the Board of Selectmen, I believe, would be also a part of the buy the new apparatus, wouldn't they? Mm-hmm. Although with a strong chief.
I think with the strong chief, there's actually.
Maybe we don't even have it. We don't even have it.
Yeah. I mean, basically, we're giving him a sense that if he were to come back to us with a transfer request on the 25th, we would approve it.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
That's.
Now, what is the total on this request again? How much would it?
It would probably be a max of $3,500.
Okay.
With $3,000 coming back once the SCBA, hopefully once the SCBA compresses. Potentially, yeah. I understand that.
Yeah. I'm also in favor.
Yeah, I'm in favor, sure.
Yeah. How about you and Ann and Joe?
I'm in favor.
Thank you.
So am I.
Okay.
Good.
All right, well, thank you for.
Do you want to vote now?
We'll vote on the actual, because the request might be for $3,200.
All right.
So. Yeah, thank you for coming in.
Okay, thank you very much. Have a good night.
You too.
Okay, everyone's still there?
Yes.
All right. So the next transfer request is the sewer in the amount of $398.85. And this is the latest iteration of the Whitewater issue that we discussed at the previous couple meetings. Does anyone have any comments or questions?
Will this be it?
My guess is we'll get a June one, probably for about $400 as well. Oh, and I forgot, just as helpful background, as of tonight, we have 37,000 $613.89 in our reserve fund.
Yeah, our reserve. That's in this fiscal year?
Yep, FY19.
Okay.
Is there a motion to approve?
Yes.
Alright, so I'll say Connie and Craig. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
And then the last transfer request is for $6,141.53 to be transferred to the legal budget. I forwarded you the first pages of the law firm's invoices. Any questions? Okay. Is there a motion to approve?
Move to approve.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
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 Okay.
Was Anne?
Oh, Anne, did you say yes?
I did say yes.
Okay. And then the only other thing that I wanted to just briefly discuss is that it's a scheduling thing. We're going to meet on the 25th. And then I know that Joe and Ann are So what I'd like to do is, if you want to call into that meeting, I'm going to try to have our July 2nd meeting be like the cleanup for anything, because otherwise we're pushing, we're getting kind of far into July. Sound good?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Sounds good.
It makes sense, but I may not be available, but we'll see.
Okay.
I may be in C.
So you... have fun, Joe. all right, anything else?
So you said 27,000. We're probably going to send another 3,000 on its way.
37.
No, it's 27 after you take
it. Oh, after.
If I read correctly.
Yeah.
Well, that was... So if we just, let's assume 3,500 is out the door, plus the 6,000 for legal, plus the 400 for sewer.
Okay.
So then we're at 27.
Yeah.
Okay. And how much are we replenishing it for next year? Are we going to be back in a worse than usual condition? Because don't we start with usually 100 in this count?
No. Well, so we'll, for FY20, we will have 100 as of July 1. And then my guess is at next annual town meeting, we'll probably need to throw in 20 or 25. But yeah. I mean, has that...
Sometimes no, sometimes we're there.
Yeah.
Sounds good. I'm just surprised that this year we would burn through $75,000 and next year we'll burn through nothing or almost nothing. We're at 20,000.
So no, we'll burn through.
We
just
only
want to start with
plus whatever we approved.
Yeah, so.
What do you mean?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're starting the year with 100,000 and we're down on 27,000. A minute ago, you said that the replenishment next year would be 20,000 or something?
Like 25.
Okay. So that sounds like you're not planning to spend more than 25 during that thing, unless I'm
missing. No. So this. So.
That gives 100.
We have 27,000 left out of a total of 125 that was appropriated in FY19.
Okay.
And so I think we're gonna probably end up in a similar.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Whatever.
I'm hoping.
Yeah. And then, just so everyone knows, the library will be coming in on the 25th to discuss a transfer request, but I don't have to.
Well,
no. Which way? Normally they contribute back to the general fund.
There's nothing set in stone. They're trying to wait until as close to the end of the year so that they have hard numbers, but it looks like that they might be running low on their payroll to get through the end of FY19.
Yeah. Overtime?
I don't think so. But I, to be honest, I don't know all the details yet, but the trustees will come in at 7 o'clock to give us all the information. So I'll ask Kelly Collins to try to send us any paperwork a couple days in advance if she has it.
Can we have the notch
paper? Oh, yeah, you know what? I'll make a note for that. Ask the notch.
Okay, I have one question. Did I miss the mail saying that there was going to be a meeting tonight and another one on the 25th? I don't mind getting notified, but I really only found out about this meeting yesterday. I guess I could have looked on the website Friday, maybe I'd seen that. Maybe I didn't see the mail, or?
Yeah, I concur.
I wasn't here for the last one, so I'm not sure what.
I don't think we planned because we were doing a doodle to figure out who could be.
Yeah, the last thing I remember was the doodle.
Yeah, that might be. That's probably not me.
Okay, that's right.
We didn't get the
doodle. Because then I saw back and forth and then you texted me.
Town secretary. Okay, we're together.
Okay. Yeah, for some reason, I thought that we got an email from last week, but it might have just been to me. So I apologize.
Yeah, that's fine.
We're here.